Hey guys, how you going? Kara here. I'm going to be doing a vlog style video today, just something a little bit different to what I've been previously doing in my other videos where I've been sitting down. I will be sitting down at some point and answering the 19 questions tag that Drew and Sarah from Look Mum and Hustling tagged me in. Unfortunately, you may also see me karaokeing supercalifragilisticexpialidocious that Rob from the Aussie VHS Thrift tagged me in, so maybe fast forward that. But most of the time, I'm just going to be going about my day. I'm going to show you guys some things I picked up yesterday. I went to three different places and I grabbed a few things, Savers, Vinnies, and also a few things I need to package up and send. But yeah, come along with me. Some other people you may see mentioned in my vlog today is Ruby and Finn. Ruby is a little multi Shih Tzu cross and she's nearly 7 years old. Oh, being all cute. And this is Finn. He is four now, I believe. We don't know what breed he is. We got him when he was 6 weeks old. He was one of my fosters as I foster animals. And he was my ninth foster and he was the sweetest thing and he was just meant to stay with me. So that's what he did, but they're my dogs and they bark a lot and they do random shit, but I love them. I made a sale last night. I made two sales actually. I'm gonna grab them out and just prep them. I'm not going to be posting them today. It is Saturday, but it is in box B. Oh, this is my storage system for my clothes. Okay. So this blouse, actually, this is not the one that I've sold, but it's funny that this is in here. Someone messaged me on eBay this morning letting me know that someone is using my pictures in the UK, and it's annoying because it's not like I've sold this yet and they're using my pictures. I messaged them and told them to stop using them, so hopefully they will. They probably won't, but I know the blouse is here somewhere. I'm not going to be doing this very well. There it is. This is a Witchery blouse. Gonna grab that. So the other things that I've sold and I was waiting payment on are these two things. That is a dress by Thurley. Sold that for $65. These are Lee jeans. I sold them for $25. These sold on sale. They're the ones that I just pulled. This is just a Witchery blouse. That sold for $17.50. And also a Trivial Pursuit, which sold for 17 something as well. Maybe even 17.50 as well. Picked up quite a variety of stuff yesterday, which was good. I like to keep everything pretty diverse in my eBay store, and it's just fun to pick up other stuff than just the same things over and over again. First thing is a big bag of plush. I got 10 plush for $5, which is really good. One of my favorite stores do that, and so I grabbed a bag because there was quite a few that I liked. This is a Simba plush. He's still got his tag. He's quite big. He's not a vintage one, but that's okay. I have been picking up a lot of these TY Beanie Boos. I sell them in lots. I'm just been collecting quite a few recently, so pretty much all of those are going a lot. There's some bigger ones as well. I've been using my two Aussie Thrifters, tote shout out. At Savers, I grabbed this review skirt. Now, with Savers, especially in Australia, some of the stuff is just, it's too expensive to buy to resell. And even this and the next top I'll show you was, you know, fairly expensive for resale standards, but I know that I can sell them. So I was like, I'm just gonna grab them. So this is a beautiful review skirt and it's a size 12, which is a really good size. I paid $10.99, so $11, but I know that I can flip this for $40 and I just won't take less than $40 because it's really pretty and I know I can get that. The next one is this revival top and I paid $7. I don't think I've ever paid $7 for a revival top before. But Savers usually price these up. This is from Dangerfield in Australia. So they do this revival brand. And I just really liked the keep your ship together. Thought it was pretty cute. Very punny. So I'm probably going to try to flip this on a specific Facebook group for Dangerfield Revival Princess Highway clothing. So there'll be no fees on it. What else did I get from Savers? I grabbed these Stuart Weitzman heels. They're actually quite a larger size, which I'm happy with. I probably wouldn't have picked up a smaller size. I don't know, maybe I would have. They were only $10 and Savers shoes, you know, are ridiculous. They can go up to $30. So I was pretty happy with these. They're like this snake skin slingback, and I'm not 100% sure what I'm going to price them at yet. They're a ladies 12, but they've just got a tiny bit of wear at the bottom. But other than that, they're in really good condition. These are some comfort shoes, and also $9.99 I paid. They are new. This is a brand, Cabello. I don't know if you had to see it. There it is. I've been really researching a lot of comfort shoes lately. It just seems like they go for really good money, and I see them so often, so I'm really trying to figure out which ones are the best to always pick up, and these definitely are. So I'm probably going to price these at $60 to $80. I'm not 100% sure yet. They're super ugly, but people love them, so, you know, you do you, boo. What else did I get at Savers? This is a decidual bag. It is in quite good condition. The only thing is it does have like a little pen mark there, which is fine. I'll try to get it out. If not, I'll just sell it as is. I did pay $10 for this as well, but I think I'll be able to get like at least 40 for it, even with the little mark on it. I grabbed this C.S. Lewis box set, and this seems like a good buy. I'm not going to make heaps of money on it, but this is probably will be the only one available in Australia. How much did I pay? I paid $5, but you know, I'm going to make more money on it, so that's okay. Last thing I got at Savers, I'll do a little bit of a... So, the reason I grabbed this, and I got this at a really good price, $3.99. It is super heavy. It's really nice quality. I know a bit more than normal people would about glass, especially vintage glass. Mostly Scandinavian glass, and this stood out to me as being vintage and also possibly Scandinavian. Usually glass, Scandinavian glass, only had stickers to say what they were, you know, like Itala, Costa Boda, things like that. So they just, you know, people pull them off when they get them, so it's hard to actually show what they are. I've actually got a bottle. I'll show you guys. Excuse my messy kitchen. Oh my God. Don't look. So I kept this sticker on. Made in Finland. And this is an Itala bowl. It is something I use to put fruit in. But this is also Scandinavian glass. Really nice. Heavy as well. Some other stuff. I grabbed some Docs. These are just some classic Docs. They've got a tiny bit of creasing at the front there, but they are made in England, so they're the good ones. The bottom is super, super clean. I paid $20 for them, but guys, these will sell. You know, I'm thinking between 70 to 80 for these, so. Last couple of things is this beautiful Colorado bag. This is a leather sort of brand in Australia. It's quite a small bag, as you can see from my hand, but I only paid, what should it be, $8. And it's really nice, and the strap's really good. A tip would be, when you're buying bags, is just check the straps right near the edges. I actually bought one yesterday. Another bag which was an offshoot of Fossil, and I was really happy that I found it, and I got back to the car and I was like, shit, I didn't check the strap. Had a look and it was broken. It was like nearly threadbare, so I took it back in and got my money back, because they shouldn't be selling that stuff if it's like nearly broken. Last pair is these Echo shoes. I think these are leather. They feel leather. Yep. All leather upper, which means the whole top of the shoe is leather and the bottom is not. And the bottoms look a little bit scuffed up, but I paid $6 and the tops look really nice. So they've got a rubber bottom and a leather top. So this is actually a plant in my garden and something's been eating it. And it ain't no bug, because look at those massive munch marks. Now, I'm pretty sure it's a rat, which is really annoying. But it's been eating it because it's obviously really hot in Australia at the moment, and especially in South Australia and, well, everywhere really. So it's been eating it because it's trying to get moisture from it, and it sucks, but that's my plant, man. You can't be eating that. Okay, so I'm going out to get some rat poison or something like that. Yeah, it doesn't sound nice, but can't be eating my shit, rat. Okay guys, I'm sorry you had to witness that. I don't know if I want to say thanks, Rob, for tagging me in that, but I did it. Now I've got to pass the buck. Of course I'm going to pass it to Brad and Jazz, two Aussie thrifters. I want to see you guys sing, or pretend to sing. I want to give you something easy, because also I don't want you to get copyrighted. I'm not even sure if I'll get copyrighted if I sing, because I sung Mary Poppins. But I'm going to get you to sing Heads and Shoulders, Knees and Toes. Now I hope you know what that song is, and it may be an Australian thing, but it's something they used to sing on play school back in the day, so you gotta do that. But it wouldn't be thrift karaoke without actually going to the thrift, so I'm at Salvo's that you can't see. I'm gonna take you along. Let's go. Things in there, two board games and that Disney picture frame, which is really cool. It's from Disney Resort. I do tend to pick up Disney Resort stuff and Disney Tokyo, Disney Sea, things like that. But now I'm at the hardware store and I'm just gonna go get some stuff to get rid of the rat.
these are some plants that are native to Australia. Drow hardy. This is a kangaroo's paw. Got some of these. Really pretty. These are great when they flower. It's been a hard season for hydrangeas. It's just too hot in Australia. Look at them dying. Hello! Oh my goodness! Things I did pick up at that op shop, the Salvation Army, so expensive in there. Some of the things, like, had men's shoes for $35. Like, yeah, no, that's not happening. But you can always find some stuff. This is so cool. It is a Disney Resort Diamond Celebration, so that is pretty cool. Nice for $3. Got a family feud. This is sealed. That's why I picked it up. They had three other family feuds. One of them was not in the box and was $10, and this was $8. I just don't get it. And then I already have another one of these. They are pretty good. Have a look at comps on eBay. Atmosphere the Mummy. And how much did I grab that for? $7. Why not? It looks like I'm about to read you guys a story or something. Okay, I'm going to do these 19 questions that Drew and Sarah from Look Mom I'm Hustling tagged me in. I've got them here on my other phone. So I'll just start at the top and I'm going to go through them. Number one, what does your channel name mean? So my channel name is actually my Instagram name, except on Instagram it's Thrifty Pixie with a one at the end. Down here it's just Thrifty Pixie. I really want to get Thrifty Pixie Instagram without the one on the end, but it's a bit of a play on words, and not many people know this. I think I've told a few people, but I really love Harry Potter, and I love thrifting, and one of my favourite scenes in Harry Potter is when Gilderoy Lockhart is with the kids in the classroom, and he lets the pixies out, and all the kids, you know, go crazy and stuff. So I just put Thrifty Pixie together. Yeah, that's what it means. Where was I born? I was born here in Adelaide in South Australia. At the Queen Elizabeth Hospital, and there's not much else to say about that. Where am I now? I'm at home. I'm still in Adelaide, South Australia. I did move to Perth for a little while. I was there, I can't remember if it was 4 or 5 years, but then we moved back. We've been here about 2 years or more, back in Adelaide. Number four, what would your parents have named you if you were the opposite sex? I had to ring my mum about this because I wasn't 100% sure, but she said it would have been Elliot, which is pretty cute. I like that name. My eye colour, it is blue. Your favourite candle scent? I love lots of candle scents. I'm a candle person or a diffuser person. I really like lemon scents for diffusers, or like a really natural scent. Candles, like, I love coconut and things like that, or like natural scents again. Can you cook? I can cook, but I don't like cooking. I just don't like it. I love food, but I don't like cooking, which I really should learn to like it, but I'm nearly 30 now and I haven't learned to like it, so I'm probably not gonna like it. What's my star sign? I am a Leo. I was born in August. What scares you about getting old? This is a deep question, this one. I guess probably the same as everyone else. Well, not everyone, but just not being able to do the things that I love. And also, we do seem to have a bit of dementia, I guess, in our family. And my nana passed and she had severe dementia. So I'm really not looking forward to that. I already have a really bad memory. So I think that's where I'm headed, unfortunately. Number 10. What's the last thing you bought? It's not the greatest thing. You guys did see me go to Bunnings, and that is where I bought some rat sack, unfortunately, to get rid of some rats. I don't know what the other humane way to do it is, really. What's your favorite holiday? I think this is holiday as in Christmas, Easter, things like that. It would definitely be Christmas. I love Christmas. What is your guilty pleasure? I would say probably just doing nothing. Like, doing nothing. Just being lazy. I definitely have a lazy streak. But when I get going, I'm pretty productive. I have to be because I work at home. But I also like binge watching series and things like that, which does lead on to the next question, which was, what show do you binge watch? I binge watch all the shows. If I really love it, I'm going to binge watch it. The most recent one my husband and I binge watched was The Witcher. I really liked that. Recommend. What item do you never leave the house without? My phone, my wallet, and my keys. Definitely my phone, though. I have left the house a few times without my keys, which was not good because I locked myself out. Are you an evening or morning person? I used to be a morning person when I worked from like an office, and now I'm not. Now I'm an evening person. I stay up too late, you know, 11, 12 o'clock at night when I really should be going to sleep. But yeah, I still don't mind getting up in the morning, but I'd rather sleep till like 8 o'clock. What's your favourite movie genre? I love historical movies and I like horror movies. What's good in your life right now? I'm happy. I have my puppies, I have my husband, I have a lovely house. We are looking at going towards no debt except for like our cars and our home. But yeah, definitely just being happy with myself, especially. I've had issues in the past with not being that happy and having a bit of anxiousness and depression, but mostly anxiety, well, and depression. But I still get anxious a lot. I overthink things. I never used to be like that. It's sort of just in the last couple of years, stresses of life and things like that. I'm sure that a lot of you know what I mean. Are you an introvert or an extrovert? I am both. I think I'm an extroverted introvert, as in I love being around people and not the life of the party as such, but I do like a good party. I like chatting with everyone and having a good time and being out and about. I don't always like being at home. Sometimes I just need to get out of the house, but then I can get exhausted from it, like just being around people as well, and eventually I'll just want to not be around them, and I'm happy just being by myself. And I had to learn that because my husband is FIFO and has been on and off for a really long time. So being able to be happy in my own company is something that I'm quite good at. Sometimes I've had moments where I'm not, and that's down to loneliness, I guess, but I always keep myself busy. I'm quite good at that. I always find something to do. I'm definitely a hobby maker. Like, I love to find things to do that I can continue to do throughout my life. So things like, you know, reselling. Number 19, what is your biggest accomplishment? This is a hard one. And I'm still thinking about it. I don't know. I'm someone who didn't finish high school. I didn't go to uni. I left school. I got a job. I have worked my way up in the corporate sort of world, and I do work from home now and make a decent wage, which is nice. I think my biggest accomplishment probably is just getting through life and being in like a really good place at the moment with finances and things like that, and to the point where we have two houses, we have two doggies, and yeah, just liking life is an accomplishment in itself, I think. So yeah, I'm gonna say that's my accomplishment. I think that wraps it up really. I did the 19 questions. I am just gonna finish off my day now. It's gonna be pretty boring, I think, the rest of it, so I'll finish the video here. Thank you so much for watching. If you got to the end, please give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe if you like to see some more of me and my dogs and my reselling, but enjoy the rest of your day. I'll see you later. Bye.